Hey guys, this is Julia here with Konkan Can Do, and today I am showing you how to reformat your WD My Passport to work on your Mac. It's really easy. Stay tuned. So I have been purchasing these WD or Western Digital external hard drives for a while now. Initially, I started out with this 1 terabyte external hard drive. I really love it. I love how small and compact it is, but you know, it didn't take very long with all of the videos that we started filming to run out of space. I love them. I'm sure that there's probably better things out there, but to be honest, I love Costco. It's really convenient for me, and so that's how I always get these. The thing is, the ones you buy at Costco aren't always immediately compatible with your Mac. Usually it requires some reformatting. Thankfully, it's actually really easy, and so I'm just gonna get started. If you have any files already stored on your external hard drive, you'd better back them up, transfer them somewhere else, because otherwise they are gonna be gone. Because everything on here is going to be erased. Let's get down to business here. So I'm just gonna plug it into my computer here. If you haven't reformatted yet, there's a chance that it may not show up, but don't panic. All you gotta do is go to the little search icon up here and type in disk utility. I've already typed it in, so it remembers it. Press enter, and you're gonna see everything internal here. Don't touch it. And then here you're gonna see all your external stuff. So I have a couple of these passports. As you can see, this is my older one that it remembers here. 1 terabyte, I don't need to worry about that. This is the one that has been plugged in. So you can see that it's got this secondary thing here. We wanna concentrate on this one. So all we're gonna do is we are going to go to erase. I'm going to do it to Mac OS extended journals. Now, this is only going to make it compatible with our Mac. If I want it to be compatible with my PC as well, I'm gonna have to change that to exFAT. Now, I have had problems, and this may not happen to all of you, but sometimes I want to format it to exFAT. But in order to do that, for some reason, I need to format it first to Mac OS extended, and then after I've done that, reformat it to exFAT. So I'm going to reformat it just for Macs for this. So here we are, I'm going to press erase, and it's working away. Mounting disk. You know that it's worked because now all of a sudden it's saying, do you want to use Untitled 4 terabyte to back up with Time Machine? Well, it's up to you. Definitely want to make sure that you have backed up. I like to keep things separate usually, so I'm not going to do that, but I'll let you decide. If you want to use this 1 4 terabyte buddy here to do a Time Machine backup as well as store some files, you're gonna have to partition it first. And I'll show you how to do that in another video. All right, and go to Get Info. We can see that it is available to be used with Mac. Hooray! Just make sure that when you are ejecting, that you eject properly and you don't just unplug, because that can also cause problems. So, eject, good. That's how it's done, guys. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to put them below. Just remember again, if you have files on here, they're gonna be gone, so back them up somewhere else, okay? That's it. This is Julia with Konkan Can Do. If you're here and you liked it, you found it helpful, I'd appreciate a big thumbs up. Okay guys, I'm out. See you next time.